Verfilmt. Verfilmt. Hallo, wie das heißt. Was das heißt? Ja, das heißt. Ah, alright. People of Fairfield, we know it's today is hot. It's a hot weather. But God will give us a refreshment and make the things refreshing for us. And this young man, they preach the gospel of the good news because the time is so short and the Lord Jesus is coming very soon. People, they have churches, but they are not really coming out of church with anything. They go in, they go out, and it's probably the same. Because 2 days ago, there was a customer who came and he said to me, he has a girlfriend, he's not a young man, he's a middle-aged man, or maybe he's in early, late 50s, and he has a girlfriend. And he said that he loves her, but he's not in love with her. And I keep thinking of that word. So today, Fairfield, I know that most of you love the Lord Jesus because you're born into Christian family. But there is a difference between you loving the Lord and being in love with Him. And I never understood the concept of that, but when I keep thinking of it, are you in love with the Lord Jesus? The way that He was in love for you? Because the love that He has for the bride took Him to the cross. He died for His bride. None of us will die even for the closest to us, the precious to us. No one will die even for a child, his child. But I'm telling you today, the Lord Jesus loved you to a measure that He took Him to the cross for you and I to have eternal life. And that religious spirit who is in that Fairfield area has to leave, because the real Christian should show up in the last hour. We are really should show the face that the Christian has, the face who can move mountains, the face who can raise the dead, not the face that dead which make us all leave our countries in a war and thinking we are kicked out of our nations. That's not the face of Jesus. So today, stop being loving the Lord and I go to church. What church do you go to and what do you do in church? And what the church is doing for you? Are you different when you enter from the way you came out? Or you're the same thing religious? Praying your rosary and do not know anything about the Lord Jesus. I'm going to ask you, when was the last time you read the Word of God? When was the last time you opened the Bible and read into it? And you think you're Christian, you think you love the Lord. You think that when He comes, He will pick you. Just be careful. Loving Mary will not take you to anywhere. Mary, she said, whatever He say to you. So you pray for the Lord, and He said, anything you ask in my name will be granted to you. I just want to ask here the Fairfield area, when was the last time you asked something in the name of Jesus? When was the last time you asked Him to do something for you that no one can do except God the Creator? You pay for your saints, and your saints are very upset with you. Very upset. Because anything take the place of the divinity is wrong. Saints are human beings. The saints are human beings. Charvel is a human being. He died and we have his place. And half of the generation are on his name. And the other half is on Nina's name. Why? Jesus is your savior. He said, if you love anyone more than father or mother or brother or wife more than me, you do not deserve me. Christian of Fairfield, I'm talking to you because the hour is soon. And if you not really step into the face which you make you love, fall in love with the Lord. Not just loving, love Jesus. Really? If you love Jesus, you can go crazy and go everywhere and anywhere to save His children who are pretending being Christian and they're not. They are not. The churchgoers, the abunas or the father's followers, but they never follow Jesus Christ. If you follow Jesus, carry your cross and follow Him. He'll take you to one place, and that place is the Calvary. Then when you get face death, a real one, you're going to be stronger. The Church of Jesus Christ was always discriminated. And I'm just going to announce to you today that the level of terrorism on the government, global terrorism, will be rising day after day. If you think it's worse today because we are obliged to have a mask,
This is just the beginning. They're gonna force us to do whatever they want. Why is that? It's not like I'm talking to you story and trying to make you afraid. That's the opposite way around. I just want you to know what the Lord Jesus and why he's prophesying the word of God. Because when you know what is written in the word of God, you will really understand and have a prospect where I should be sitting. There is no one will sit on the fence, guys, anymore. If God is God, you will worship him. And if he's not, you don't worship him. Go and live your life as you like. There is no jokes. The time is close. Brother and sister, check your face if you really are in the face, which take you to a place that what Jesus took, the cross, and he was rejoicing because he was seeing your face when he was walking on that path of the Calvary. And then the woman came and they took the and tried to wipe his face because he was sweat and there was blood on it. And he said, for Jerusalem, look after your children. Today the word of God is talking about an era where there is an end of the human government. Human government will come to an end. But the last episode of the human government, there will be a universal governor. And that governor will be so cruel. That was the word of God talking about him. He will be so cruel. He will force all the nation to do his will. There will be no one capable of opposing him or say no. So if you have a problem today with the mask, just wait a little bit longer. He will do his will on all the nations. It's already started from last year. All the nations have one rule. And it's like the governor is there. But he's not yet manifest. There will come the time that he will be manifest. And he will be a ruler which rule on a government area globally. When he will be announced, there will be coming 7 years of terrors on humankind. They never seen before since the beginning of the creation. So today, are you prepared for the coming of the global terror governor, or are you ready for the coming of Christ as his bride? Because there will be a blow. There will be the last trumpet on the air. The angel of the Lord will announce that children of God will be snatched in a minute, in a twinkle of an eye. And all of them will be with the Lord Jesus for 7 years. What's happening on the earth here is very undesirable. So this governor is about to show himself to the world, to be revealed. This is the prophecy written in many places, the book of Daniel, in Zechariah, and it's prophesied in the New Testament in the Thessalonians 1 and 2. Just read it, brother and sister, because there is no secrets for the time, the future of humanity. God showed very in details, in all the details, and when and why and how. So for you not to be able to know it as a Christian, that's not right. Because people will be totally afraid of the things coming on the human world. And they have to obey. So today we have a fine of $200 for not having the mask. And many of us, and you can see people who obey this rule or who don't obey this rule. They put terror in heart of people. And people are terrorized even more. They can control us because of the fear. But wait and see when this global governor will come. And the shift and the move of the things yet to come for humanity. There will be no joke. He will have no mercy. He will not regard any nation. He will have no fear for any god, and he will have tendency for women. This is what is written about him into the book. So be careful. And he will have a sign on his hand, his withered hand, and a blind eye. So this all said about him. So it's very, very specific description. And many people know about that, especially from the Muslim world. They know about the Mahdi who will come with this description. But for us, it's called the Antichrist. That global, universal ruler who is coming to destroy all liberty and all freedom and all respect human beings will have for themselves and for others. When I was seeing into the already people coming and they threat the others because they don't put the mask. We already seeing this because this was prophesied more than 2,000 years. that a man will go and take his family, his children, his parents. He's gonna report them, and they will take them to death. So this prophecy has been starting to reveal and to be revealed among our eyes and unfolded, and the time will come where the fullness of this description, of the very, very clear description of the Bible, will be seen to people in front of you. But which way you wanna go? To that governor, ruler, who will force you to do only his will. Either as a nation, all nation has to obey him, and the nation will come into resistance. He will open them in a, he will really ruin them. So nationwide around the world, they have to obey that ruler, that governor, that global government will come, and they will rule the whole world by iron, by no jokes. So you be ready for that one, or you be ready for the coming of God. God in the flesh, he will come and he will show up. He take only his children to the place of rest for 7 years, when everyone will receive his reward according to his deeds. But you guys, don't play around. Because if you think you have time, you don't. And if you think the things get better as we go with this virus and this ruling, don't. Because of the prophecy, as Jesus said in Matthew 24, there'll be wars and there will be famines, and he said as well, plagues, in plural. So this is not gonna be one. This is already a man-made destruction of humanity, or forcing humanity to do whatever they want. And they test us in the measure of obedience. We have to obey what they say. And I'm here not to tell you to disobey the rulers. No, that's not my place. I'm not an activist here, but I'm an evangelist, which means I preach the evangel, the word of God, for you to have eternal life and to be solid about your faith. I want all Iraqi people and Assyrian, listen to me carefully, because the Lord evacuated them instantly. They were thinking the Islam pushed them out, but it was not. That was the will of God. He wanna rescue his children. So you guys are evacuated in the time of God, because the second plan of the global ruling of that cruel, he's cruel, the description for him on the Bible is cruel. أخي وأخواتي أنا عايزة أتكلم لكم عن الفترة اللي جاية. Because في ناس كتير من اللي هنا المسيحيين الموجودين في المنطقة كانوا عراقيين أو سوريين بيفتكروا إن هم اتطردوا من بلادهم من الإسلام, and this is a big lie, دي كذبة. الرب حدد في الميعاد اللي هو عايزه يفضي الناس دول ويطلعهم من المكان اللي هم فيه عشان ينقذهم. الله عنده خطة كبيرة ليك وليك وليا. الله يرجع الشعوب بتاعته, مصر وسوريا, الأشوريين والعراقيين البابليين, هيرجعوا تاني, يرجعوا يخدموا ربنا ويبنوا مسبح في الارض, في وسط الارض. لكن الرب طلعهم من بلادهم عشان بينقذهم. هيجي حكومة شديدة, حكومة عنيفة, حكومة قاسية. كتاب بيشرحها في إشعياء 19, بيقول ايه؟ مولى قاسي, بيشرح عنه, بيقول انه مولى قاسي هيسود العالم كله, هيسود العالم كله, كل الناس هتطيعه, والبلاد اللي مش هتطيعه هيقتحمها وهيدمرها وهينهب الممالك وهياخد خزائن مصر. الكتاب بيقول كل الكلام ده بكل وضوح. مفيش واحد مسيحي يستجري يقول انا مش عارف, لان الكتاب كتب بالتفصيل في النبوات على ايه اللي هيحصل في الفترة الجاية. وابتدى عصره من السنة اللي فاتت, خلى كل الناس تطيعه في العالم كله. مفيش مرة العالم كله اتحد على قانون زي ما اتحدوا غصب عنهم على القانون الدولي دوت, والارهاب بتاعه هيزيد. لكن هو لسه ما استعلنش, موجود لكنه ما استعلنش, هيجي وقت هيستعلن, واسمه ضد المسيح. لما هيجي يكون موجود ويملك, في الاعلان بتاعه اولاد ربنا هيخطفوا على السحاب. انت عندك حل من اتنين, يا تنتظر مجيء المسيح على السحاب لما يضرب البوق الاخير وكل واحد صحيح ابن الله هيتخطف في لحظه في طرفه عين ويكون مع المسيح, ياخد مكافئات وياخد تيجان, يا هتقعد على الارض 7 سنين من العذاب والمرار اللي البشريه ما شافتوش من بدء الخليقه. كتاب المقدس شارح كل ده بالتفصيل, شرحه بكل تفصيل. النهارده انا عايزه اقول لك فجالي زبون من كام يوم بيقول لي بيعرف واحده تعرف عليها جديد الجيرل فريند بتاعته وبيقول ان هو بيحبها لكن مش واقع في حبها. لكن انا ما اعرفش اقولها ازاي بالعربي. لكن في فرق ما بينك تحب حد وانك تقع في حبه. طب حبه يعني بتفكر فيه كل الوقت. الكنيسه المسيحيه السوريه والاشوريه والعراقيه انتوا بتحبوا الرب يسوع، انا بتاعه، لكن انت بتحب مريم اكتر وبتحب القديسين اكتر، بتصلي لهم وبتطلب منهم، وعمرك ما اتعلمت تطلب في اسم يسوع. اطلب في اسم يسوع بكل ما تطلبونه وباسمي يكون لكم. امتى اخر مره طلبت باسم يسوع؟ زباين بيقولي في المحل اقول له احكي رتلي لي ترتيله عن يسوع، تقولي ما اعرفش غير عن مريم. جانت مريم مش هتنفعنا، لكن يسوع اللي مات علشانك. هل انت بتحبه من كل قلبك ومن كل فكرك ومن كل قوتك؟ هل انت مستعد تمشي وراه في الصليب، تشيل الصليب وتتبعه؟ يا اخي يا اختي، دي الساعه الاخيره وما عندناش وقت كتير ان احنا نضيعه. لو انت بتحبه من كل جوارحك زي ما هو حبك وهو ماشي ناحيه الصليب وبقى يقع تحت الصليب والست تمسح وشه بالدم والدموع، كان قدامه صورة واحدة، صورتك، كان بيفكر فيك، كان بيفكر فيا. So today I'm just encouraging you not just to love the Lord but fall in love with him. To be in love with him. And to be in love with him is to make everything to please him. لما انت فعلا تقع في حبه وفي غرامه، you will think about him all day and night. Why should I do to please him? What are the things that can make him heart happy? Christian, I'm not doing that. I just get a guy 2 days ago from Egypt. And he was trying to evangelize me, to tell me, people will see my good works. And they will turn to Christ. I said, that's why the Middle East is lost. Because no one sees your good works. You're a coward. You don't want to explain. What is the true faith that you have and the life that you have in Christ? كل المسيحيين هناك بتوع مصر يقول لك ايه؟ يروا اعمالكم الحسنة. انت ما عندكش اعمال حسنة ترى. انت جبان. وانت جبانة. لو عندك قدرة تعلني المسيح والحياة اللي في المسيح، كان نص العالم الاسلامي دخل في الحياة الحقيقية. لكن اعمالك واعمالي will never show anything. Your good works will never bring people to the Lord. Because we are dying world and we are in the last hour. I'm calling for the Assyrian and Iraqi and Lebanese and Egyptian to raise up on that hour. Because the revelation of the book of Isaiah 19, this area of the world, out of it will come the revival. And the altar of Christ will start from there. Read it on Isaiah 19. Come on and let us read it together. We'll start in Egypt and the Assyrian and then Israel in the end. And this triune in Isaiah 19, go read it for yourself. And love the Lord the way that he loved you. Stop being cowards. No one will see your good works. But they will see your faith. Because this is a time and an hour who took Christ to the cross. ساعة دي أخذت المسيح للصليب. أنت قاعد تعمل إيه؟ ها؟ هل إيمانك ده حقيقي؟ هل أنت بتحب الرب زي ما حبك؟ أخي يا أختي، أنا عايزك تفوق، لأنك أنت قدامك حاجة من اتنين. يا إما هتاخد المجيء التاني مع المسيح في السحاب وتكون معاه وتبقى عروس المسيح الحقيقية اللي بتحبه، أو هتكون بتنتظر ضد المسيح اللي هيجي ويهلك العالم. اختار الحاجة اللي أنت عايزها. And I'm just asking you that you do the right choice. Say, I want to be with you, Jesus. I want to be with you, Jesus. Are you Christian? Are you Christian?
Yes.
Do you love the Lord?
Yes.
Do you want to die for him?
No.
Then I cannot give you my mic. I'm sorry.
Yes.
I just want Christian who want to die for Christ.
Yes.
I want a Christian who want to die for him. You know why? Because he died for you. And he never think twice. Stop being coward, man. Middle East, arise. Middle East people, they are the people who are going to give the revival around the world. They're starting from Egypt. They start, go read Isaiah 19 and come and talk to me about that altar. Why do you want to talk in my mic if you don't want to die for him? Do you want to die for Christ?
Of course.
Then yes, that mic is yours.
Of course.
Okay.